You know me as Vicki Vale, the photographer who teamed up with Batman to fight evil in the comic strip world of Gotham City. But today, I'm involved in a real-life fight against evil. A deplorable evil right here in America, and there's nothing comic strip about it at all. Many Americans are fighting a grotesque brutality which must be stopped. Trappers and fur traders followed behind early explorers to the American wilderness. Cruelty to wildlife took hold there, and the main instrument of torture, the leg hole trap, is still in use today. We are going to see the leg hole trap and other kinds, filmed in action on a real trap line. We're going to witness the agony they inflict on innocent animals. We're going to ask ourselves, how can such a barbarity be allowed in a civilized society? This is the leg hole trap, invented more than 200 years ago. Millions of them are in use today. The primitive wire snare, which pulls tighter and tighter and tighter. The conibear trap, said to be the state of the art in modern quick kill design. And the cruelest joke of all, the padded leg hole trap, recently invented. They claim the padded jaws make it humane. The leg hole trap, padded or otherwise, rarely kills quickly, if at all. Animals chew their limbs free or twist them off, or simply die from cold or starvation. Regulations requiring trappers to check traps frequently to limit the agony are virtually unenforceable. The conibear trap kills quickly if the animal obliges by trapping itself properly. If not, it suffers unspeakably. The snare is hit and miss at best, and the agony can last for days. Trappers claim that drowning sets for beaver and muskrat are humane. But what is the time limit on the agony? Most of us live in an urban environment, unaware of these atrocities. But they are happening, and a growing number of us are committed to stop it. I'm speaking to you on behalf of the Fur Bearer Defenders, a group of concerned citizens determined to end this unnecessary torture of our wildlife. Public outcry in America is pressuring the fur industry to change its ways, but they insist on continuing to use barbaric trapping methods. Some governments pay lip service to our concerns, then look the other way. Yet our vulnerable wildlife is entrusted to their care. Millions upon millions of our wild animals are subjected to outright torture every year. And for what? Profit? I insist that we cannot tolerate it any longer. Gandhi once said, "A nation is only as powerful as the way it treats its animals." Cruelty to animals is cruelty to ourselves. It affects me personally and you every time it happens. The animals are screaming for our help. Please join the Fur Bearer Defenders. We are determined to bring an end to this unnecessary tragedy. Please join now. And on behalf of the animals, I thank you.